Follow Active Quads. Follow Active Quads unwraps the mesh straight, starting from the active face. Follow Active Quads requires to have a quad topology. It will work with trees and N-guns, but don't give usual results with it. Follow Active Quads is, for example, handy when you have a curved road and want it to map in a way that the middle lane at the texture is in the middle of the curves too. You can map the whole mesh with this method or just a part of it. Calculated gets what is selected. Let's select everything and perform Follow Active Quads. You get a dialog here where you can adjust how the edge length gets calculated. Length average does its best to give all faces their real lengths. Same goes for length. It is not so exact and even calculates every face in the same size of the starting face. Length average is a default. And let's have a look. As you can see, it doesn't care about the UV space size. To fit the UV patch into the UV space is something that you have to adjust by yourself. Let's undo this. It can happen that the result is not straight, but distorted. That's for example the case when the mesh is already unwrapped. Let's for example unwrap with ABF. And when you now perform Follow Active Quads with this face loop, then you get a distorted result. The reason here is that this face, the active face, is not rectangular. Not fully rectangular. As you can see here, this one is this side is shorter than this side. And so this pattern follows through the whole Follow Active Quad unwrap. To fix this, we need to make the active face rectangular or choose another face that is rectangular, but here in the UV editor. So what I do now is choose this one as the active one. First, let's unwrap it with ABF so that it is rectangular. Then let's select the edge loop. Set this one as the active one. And then let's repeat Follow Active Quads. And now we have a straight line again. The last operator contains, again, the same settings than the dialog at the beginning, the edge length modes.